welcome. This is Melissa Armour with the Stock Swoosh, and I'm reviewing Disney. Guess what? Disney did not gap up. Well, it actually did. It actually was at 96 at one point in the post-market. Now it's not doing anything, actually. It just looks like a whatever. It closed tonight at 92.31. So according from the close today into where it's at right now, it's actually gapping down. Almost under support of the previous day's low. I don't think we open here, though. I think we actually probably open because the market's probably going to rally tomorrow, either gap up or neutral or run into the open. We're probably going to be dangling around here. Either we're going to be slightly below this area. We're going to open probably in Disney above the previous bar of yesterday. We're probably going to open above 90. But this isn't anything near what I wanted to see. Nothing at all, okay? And all the earnings reports were good. Once again, the correlation of what the report says doesn't necessarily have anything to do with the way the stock is going to move in the direction. I like this to gap up. It didn't do it. Now, I called an option trade in this Friday and Monday, and today you could have done it even at 35 cents. Again, today you could have bought it at 35 cents this morning. It ran up. That same one at the strike price of 98 ran up from 35 cents to 80, 86 cents, I think, was the high. I was watching it. I was in it. So it was a 50-cent profit if you did it into the run-up, okay? Because on the live day today, at one point, it was up here over 93. It looked great. But you have to sell out of some of it into the earnings. If you look at this as an investment, okay, it was almost, first of all, it was more than 100% return. It was actually a 200% return on investment if you look at it like an investment. In other words, if you had $35. You took $35 and you actually made $35, more than $35 in the $35. Okay. It was actually 1.5 times the amount that you made. So that's 150% investment on your money. So in other words, if you took 10 contracts, 1,000 shares, you spent $350. Okay. You were up 500 something on the day. So you were up 150% of your investment in the trade in one day quickly, not knowing what the outcome of the earnings is, believing, having the conviction it would gap up. It didn't do it, but knowing that you were up 150% of your investment. And this is how you have to look at it. So you have to get out of a piece of it. If you did that and got out of half of that trade, then you protected yourself, not knowing the outcome, getting out of half and letting the rest ride. Because if the rest had worked out, it would have been a huge risk to reward. It still was a huge risk to reward as a regular trade because the fact is that you got 150% return on your investment. But if you didn't get out of any, tomorrow morning, this didn't gap up, what are these going to be worth? I think actually this will rally on the day tomorrow. I don't think this drops. I don't even know why this is at this number here, but whatever. I think it rallies, but I don't know what they will be worth. Will they be worth more than 35 cents? Maybe. You've got Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I do not think this gets to 98 by Friday. So you got to get out of this by Thursday. So my advice to you is watch the stock tomorrow, see if it rallies. Watch the market tomorrow, see if it rallies. This could open around here. I think it's better if it opens at 90 and above. Holds, rallies with the market, and rallies up. And so if you did not get out of any of this today, and you were up in it, 150% return on investment, then I want you to get a new plan of action, a trading plan together for doing these. We've been talking about them in the room because Amazon and Google were great trades. Didn't follow through on the day on the gap, but we were up huge amounts of money into the earnings. You got two options. A, take it all out, sell all of it into the earnings before the announcement because you don't know where it's going to gap. Sell it all or sell half or more than half. Protect yourself so you don't lose in the trade or make money because you could take more than half off. And let the rest ride. Even if you only have a little bit of this and it had worked out, it would have been really, really big. So my advice to you going forward is use common sense. When you have a good trade, take half off. We've talked about this in the room after Amazon and Google. I did not specify this in the email. And I'm realizing now because of so many people are watching my trades and videos and emails that I'm going to start to be more specific. I'm going to say, this is the target. This is what to do. But to me, it's common sense about the money management. I know we'd all love to make $100,000 in one trade. I know we'd all love to make $1 million in one trade. I know we all want to have these huge run trades. But to be honest with you, when I went back and looked at the money I was up in Adobe prior to the earnings, okay, because the earnings and that one, it gapped up, but then it fell on the day. Amazon, prior to the earnings. Google, prior to the earnings. Disney, prior to the earnings. Alta, which worked on the day into the earnings, and Microsoft, I did. So there were six. Six from December, January, February, just since I've been doing these. If I add up all the money that I was up into the earnings, actually, I would be up more now. And I talked about this in the room on Monday. So the room is closed the rest of the week. I am working on my own trading plan for options because I think that going forward, I'm not sure if I'm going to hold any of these into the earnings. And the reason is because when I go back and look at the results from the last 2 months, I think that I'm having such great picks of the timing of the entries for the price to get the move very, very quickly within days or one day or a week that we do a couple of these and it's the same as having one big humongous one. Does this make sense? So if I had taken everything off into the earnings of all the trades I did, it's close to $60,000. Now, I did have the biggest day I ever had, you know, in January. That was fantastic. But I'll tell you, when I think about the fact if I had chunked it out, I was looking for a $100,000 trade in Google or Amazon. I didn't get it because it didn't work out right to follow through in the earnings. But if I look at all the ones I did from December to now, if I had gotten out of all the total positions into the earnings, it would have been almost 60 grand. And that's actually a lot of money. Even though I made really good money in these, and I'm getting perfect prices in these to get the run-ups, and I'm up a lot, it's still the point that I think it's better to really trade them like we do the regular trades, where we're chunking it out. Because it's never over to the fat lady sings, you don't know what the earnings are going to do. And every once in a while, you will have one that will work out to end up being massively huge. LinkedIn was one of them if you shorted it, actually. LinkedIn ended up gapping down. And I had looked at that and I didn't end up doing anything with this. Look at this. This is going to break 100. I had looked briefly at the 155s at the puts on this. They were like, you could have gotten them for like 30 cents. I didn't do it. I did not do it. And then I was like kicking myself in the butt for not more seriously looking at it. But if I had done this, that would have been a $90,000 trade because I probably would have done 20 contracts, spent $600, or maybe I would have spent more than that. And it literally went over 50 points. Yeah, it would have been 100 grand. But what I'm saying is that these are things that might happen once a year, twice a year. The trades that I'm calling that are amazing for these calls that are working, running up into the earnings from the time that we're getting them. Disney, Amazon, Google, Microsoft, you know, it's Adobe. You know, I was up $3,000 in Adobe running up into the earnings. I think these ones, I think we're going to make more money getting all out and just doing every one that I see. Oh, come on, yeah, this is taking too long. I think that's the right thing to do. Yeah, it was back in here. This was the day of the earnings, but this is the run up before the earnings. You see, then it gapped down. So, I mean, I'm working this out in my mind, but going back and looking at my results, I really think that may be the way that I play it going forward. So we'll see what happens, but I'm absolutely getting perfect entries here on these. Like, can't lose in the price that I'm buying them, but you still have to money manage yourself. So I will be thoughtful of the emails I sent out now to tell people to take half off, but this is something that I'm realizing maybe I need to do a class on because I just never dawned on the fact that people would be up a good amount of money and not think of getting out. I know we all want the huge home run trades and they're possible. They're absolutely possible. Ulta was one. Google really was one because it held in the gap up into the earnings and we were up a lot in that even in the morning before it fell. But it's, you just don't know until the earnings come out. But this is why you combine the option trades with the day trades to make money. We do the day trades and I know what it's doing. I just play the gap. And ACAM is the one to watch for tomorrow. But I will tell you that Disney really needs to open over 90 tomorrow. Really needs to open over 90 tomorrow to hold on the day. Now, I don't know if it will or not. I have no idea if it will. But this is still a good long. You just have to be very, very mindful of your money management and try to use common sense, because this was a good trade in here to do yesterday or today, because it ran up 150% in your investment. And if you did it and bought it anywhere at 35, 40 cents, it ran up to 86 for the 98. And some people might have gotten a better strike price than I did. I think one person told me they did the 95s and one person did the 96s. And they were up even more. You just got to make sure that you get out of something when you're up. Don't let a trade that you're positive go against you. This is common sense, but I'm realizing that I need to be more specific with people so they understand what they need to do. Don't try to go for the home run with all of your position size. You have one goal: make money. Take quality picks, quality entries. You don't have to hold the whole thing to the target to make money. You can consistently make money using my Golden Gap system, but don't bet the farm on everything for every trade to go to the target. Okay? It's about chunking it out. And I'm realizing with the options that I might get out of the full positions before the earnings, going back and looking at my results. But I haven't decided yet. For now, we're just going to continue getting out of half or more than half into the earnings. But I'm thinking about what I'm going to do with this starting next week when we're back from the holiday. All right, have a good night, everyone. Email me at melissa@thestockswoosh.com if you want more information. Have a good day.